We all know which court to go to whenever our rights are violated. But where do the countries go when their rights are transgressed by another country? Of course, we know that too. To the United Nations. Where else? In the history of mankind, there has never been a bigger international forum than the United Nations or UN, where virtually all countries of the world are a member, 193 to be precise. Then why is United Nations hailed as the most successful experiment towards world peace by some and denounced as one of the biggest failures by its critics? Let's first understand the objective behind its formation. Post-unprecedented destruction caused during World War II, 51 countries of the world got together and signed for formation of United Nations during the year 1945 as the biggest intergovernmental organization. For a larger objective of promoting international peace and security and thus preventing World War III, the UN set out to work on two levels. A. For protection of sovereignty of its member states, and B. For protection of civil liberties and rights, assuring a dignified living for all citizens residing anywhere in the world. Isn't it fascinating that there is an organization that directly or indirectly represents 7.7 billion citizens of this world? But how is that accomplished? And why does the UN face so much criticism? Well, the UN functions at mainly three levels. 1. Six principal organs, prominently being General Assembly, Security Council, and International Court of Justice. 2. 15 specialized agencies, prominent amongst them are International Monetary Fund or IMF, UN Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization or UNESCO, World Bank and World Health Organization or WHO. 3. Scores of programs and funds such as UNAIDS, UNCTAD, UN Women and so on. All these bodies and programs are funded by the member countries in agreed proportions and managed through their nominated representatives, also by talented professionals from all over the world who enjoy tax-free salaries. As per the UN Charter, emissaries sent to the UN by the member countries enjoy special privileges as diplomatic missions, and offices of the UN are considered special geographical entities that enjoy diplomatic immunity. With a backdrop of a grand mission such as this, let's explore the successes or failures in the top programs undertaken by the United Nations. 1. Peacekeeping. With the original objective of prevention of wars, the UN actually employs troops called peacekeeping forces at a number of conflict zones all over the world. However, it has failed miserably at prevention of unabated violence and genocide throughout its existence. Prominent loss of life being at Rwanda, Bosnia, Syria, and so on. 2. Refugee crisis. We hear news from world over every day about how many people are rendered homeless, displaced from their native places, and are doomed to live in inhuman conditions along with their families. Unfortunately, the UN has achieved precious little to prevent 50 to 60 million people who are displaced every year. 3. Similarly, the UN has achieved little success in preventing human rights violations, disarmament, terrorism, narcotics control, food and water shortages, and so on. 4. To add insult to injury, 5 member countries of the most powerful UN Security Council are actually the biggest manufacturers and providers of arms to the conflict zones. 5. Besides all these, the UN is considered very expensive, bureaucratic, and riddled with corruption at various offices that lack transparency and accountability. Good God! Now we understand why so many people refer to the UN as an international talk shop for exchanging insults. With so much mistrust among the developed and the developing countries, won't it be better that the UN be disbanded? Absolutely not! In spite of all the failings, we should still back the UN for the following reasons and riders. 1. The biggest achievement of the UN is the success in preventing World War III. 2. It has succeeded in creating forums for continuous dialogues for various problems faced by humanity. 3. UN has also been successful in protecting world heritage in almost all member countries. 4. Partial success is better than no success at all. 5. But yes, the UN should be subjected to continued scrutiny and audits just like any organization. And in the end, we all would agree that the objective of UN is not to take us to heaven, but to save us from hell.